Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over how to use slicers in Excel. First, what are slicers? So slicers are groups of buttons used to filter data. Think of each group as a slice of the data. They can be used to filter data grouped into pivot tables or data formatted as an Excel table. Especially if looking at large amounts of data, this is a faster way of filtering through that data. They can also be styled, making them a great option for tasks like creating an interactive dashboard. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. On my screen is some sales data I've used to create a pivot table along with a pivot chart. And FYI, you can also use slicers for tables, but in this example, we'll be working with a pivot table and a pivot chart. So to insert a slicer, you first need to make sure that your cursor is in the active pivot table. And you can insert a slicer from the Insert tab in the Filter section or in the Tool section of whatever you're using, which in this case is the pivot tables. And I'm going to select Year, Associate, and Product and click OK. Let's organize these so we can see them a little clearer. To use the slicer as a filter, simply click the button labeled for the data that you want to filter for. So let's say I click 2016. Notice when I do that, the pivot table and pivot chart instantly updated to reflect only the information that I filtered for. We can continue filtering by moving on to the next slicer. So let's say I want to see only Jamie's results. Notice how now all of my data filtered only for what Jamie sold. Notice also how our buttons have been changing colors. The darker ones are the ones that we've selected. Here in the product slicer, hats, shirts, and swimsuits are darker. That's because they've been automatically selected for us because those are the only products that Jamie sells. Jamie doesn't sell any coats, and it signals this with a lighter blue. To select or deselect multiple items, we can click on the multi-select button here. And so in this case, these darker ones are already selected. So if we click on hats, for example, that actually deselects that and filters down for just shirts and swimsuits. We can click the multi-select in this box, and let's say we want to add Emerson to the results. Now we can see Emerson's products as well. So let's say I want to view only the slicers and the charts. So like if I'm creating a summary or a dashboard tab, I'm going to select the slicers and the chart, and using Control X, I'm going to cut them and paste them into a new tab that I created. Then I can move these so they align a little bit better and resize these to show only what is currently in them. And I can continue filtering this way. So let's say I want to change to 2017. Only Emerson, and now I have this interactive slicers and chart that I can use separately. So for more styling and formatting options for your slicers, you can come to the Slicer Tools menu, and here you can access the slicer settings. So right now we've selected product. We can change its name, decide to display it or not. How do we want to filter the items in the slicer, and what to do with those items that have no data? We can alter the report connection. So right now it's connected to our pivot table. What colors that match our current theme and alignment options and resizing options. So as you can see, there's a lot of flexibility as to how you can use your slicers to create more interactivity and easier filtering in your spreadsheets. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to use slicers in Microsoft Excel. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.